summit of this mixed doubles campaign with them involved.
It means a great deal to them as the players, Pattisak and Sutasini from Thailand, came out. They performed the Y, the traditional Thai greeting, with palms together. And we may well get a little of the musical orchestration that accompanies a lot of the Thai players. And those of you who follow sports like Muay Thai, for example, you'll know that that's an integral part, actually, of Thai sport and performance art. On the subject of things that are integral, well, competitions involving Wong and Du go hand in hand because they are experienced. They've been competing together for a long time. Both of these partnerships have, actually, haven't they, Fraser? And that makes a very interesting dynamic too.
It certainly does, Ollie. I mean, Wong Chun-Ting and Du Hoi Kem are... Oh, Wong Chun-Ting with the RPB. How on earth has he just done that? That's incredible from him. I forgot what I was just about to say, Ollie.
We're talking about the longevity they've got.
Oh, yeah. No, they're amazing. They're an iconic pair. Three-time World Championship medalists together. So they're more decorated than Soueta Butt and Pattisak. But, I mean, here on home soil, they are more than inspired to deliver. It'll be a tough one, though.
Yeah, really interesting. 2015, a sort of special year for both of these partnerships. It was the first time, as you said, that Wong and Du took a bronze medal at the World Championships. Did it again in 2017 and 2023. And also a mixed doubles silver medal at the Southeast Asian Games for Pattisak and Sutasini in 2015. They then won the title in 2017. Sutasini, 29 with the serve.
Well, nice.
Yeah, they're moving them around well, aren't they?
They are. That was a lovely loop. The ball had disappeared beneath the surface of the table. Took it so late, but still in front of her body, and produced a rainbowing, arcing shot. And the backhands all of a sudden for Wong and Du aren't landing as often as what they were.
One of the things that we often say when you've got players from the host nation in one of these star contender events, the important job for the visitors, if you will, in terms of Wong and Du, because suddenly it becomes an away fixture, is not to allow the spectators, not to allow the Thai players to get into a really almost euphoric state early on in the match.
Yes, absolutely.
Try and create a little tension. Now that required some quick footwork to deal with the net cord, and it got it.
I've seen players before who've crumbled on home soil because they feel like they've got more people to let down. They look at it the other way, but I don't think that the Thai duo are like that. I think that they take a lot of joy from it and play better as a result. But I've heard some Jayos in here. I think that that's quite a good showing for Wong and Du.
Doing exactly as we were speaking of, just creating a little tension for the home crowd early on. Suddenly things have got a little quieter. Then suddenly Pattisak and Sutasini take a point and the music begins. Lovely atmosphere. Two game points.
Wow.
Wasn't that superb? Comfortable.
They've not got a great record against Shin and Yim Jong-hoon, so you wonder when they saw that the Thais beat them, if they kind of lit their lips and thought this is our chance to do it, but what a shot.
There are athletes who will say that sometimes a competition becomes strangely harder once you know that a path has been created for you to win it.
Right. And there's been a lot of results that have indicated that could well be true.
Place that really well. Use the full extremities of the surface.
Nice fade as well there from Saweta Butts. She opened up the body, opened up the shoulders. And that's the thing that makes your opponent move to the right, and then she went to the left.
What an accomplishment it's going to be for Sudhasini Saweta Butts to competed a third consecutive Olympic Games in Paris. Still only 29 as well. And over the other side of the table you have in Du Hoi Kim, team medalist from Tokyo. Also competed in Rio. Yes, they are hugely experienced. That's a great facet of their game. But what do you think it's been that's made them such an enduring and successful partnership? Movement like that, for starters.
Well, I was going to say that the dynamism of their movement. They're both right-handed players as well, which makes it even more tougher in doubles. But they're all over the place. Not in terms of messy, but they're everywhere at once. I think they love playing with each other. They can express themselves with each other, and usually players can express themselves only when they're on their own, when they're given time and space to articulate themselves solo. So I think they've just got a special bond, Wang Chunting and Du Hoi Kim, and I think that Wang Chunting, with his penhold grip, has such an amazing forehand. And Du Hoi Kim is just so solid. She's the base. Du Hoi Kim is the base. And Wang Chunting builds upon her game. They've got that respect and understanding for each other.
And very much a Venn diagram, I suppose, of some complementary skills, some quite different skills that actually creates a very cohesive product.
And because they watch each other so much and play with each other so much, they understand the contact that the other person puts on the ball, so they're not fooled by any residual spin.
This is a good effort from Padasaka and Sudhasini.
Did well there, Padasat, because Wang Chunting's block went right down the line into his crossover.
That was a difficult one to stretch for.
He wondered whether Wang Chun-Ting was going to hit it round the net.
Could talk all day about that sanctuary in Chengdu, but I must stop pandering to it.
Oh.
Two game points. Just a very secure looking performance this from Wang and Du. It's not necessarily the most spectacular that you'll ever see from them, but it's calm and accomplished. They have it, 11-8, two-thirds of the way there. Still much more to come on our coverage of the second day of main draw competition at the WTT Star Contender in Bangkok. Thank you so much for your company, for setting aside some time to enjoy some top quality table tennis action in this tournament that, as a standalone tournament, is highly prestigious and is an important part of the WTT calendar, but also is set into the context of the impending Paris 2024 Olympiad, and that just adds a little extra salt and pepper to things. Especially when we look at a partnership here from Hong Kong, China, who will have aspirations of contending for honours.
For sure, they'll be aiming, you imagine, for at least a bronze. I mean, that's been their favourite colour, hasn't it, I guess you can say, with the three bronze medals that they've had at Worlds together. But obviously only one pair per country. It's interesting in mixed doubles, probably my second favourite event. I won't tell you what my favourite is, because that would show favouritism.
I like that. I won't say my favourite, I'll say my second favourite though.
Exactly.
Easiest one to position himself for. Again, it's that understanding they've got.
They play the parallels so well, don't they? It's amazing how they play that shorter length with such aggression. You've got Du Hoi Kem there, always taking the ball off the bounce, always just being able to hold the table so well. And then you've got Wang Chun-Ting, who is just a scattergraph of movement all over the place, firing his shots in.
Advantageous perhaps to Parasak and Sudhasini that they have got the timeout still to deploy if they need it. Lovely little angle from Wang Chun-Ting.
Just look at those sideburns, the Elvis of Hong Kong, China. He knows what he's doing, doesn't he, Wang Chun-Ting?
It's a very clear and effective sartorial choice, isn't it?
Certainly is.
Well, at the moment, it is their opponents who are all shook up.
Oh.
Didn't they play that so calmly from such depth?
Beautiful. It's just so amazing. Yeah.
Never for a moment did you think they weren't going to win that point.
Ooh. Well, that push of Wang Chun-Ting, I'd love to watch that one again. That was absolutely sizzling. Came right under that with the push. like he was a little bit caught for space, but brilliant.
I do really feel here for Prasak, Tanvidi, Vichakul and Sotasini Sawetabud, because they just haven't had the chance to really get moving in this match.
And that shows you the experience of Wong Chun Ting and Du Hoi Kem, because they're not as clean. Their rhythm, their tempo isn't as constant, and that's where Yim Jong-hoon and Chin Yubin went wrong. They tried to rally against them instead of play against them. There's a difference. And that's why you've maybe seen Parasak and Suetabo just struggle to get the consistency that they had against the Koreans.
As is so often the case with Wong and Du, they take the big point. And we're going to see the timeout used here. Straight back to the table. Two match points. And that's a really well-handled match point from the Thai pair. Got to do it again. A place in the final awaits for Wong and Du. That's an unfortunate conclusion, but it doesn't mask the fact that Wong Chun Ting and Du Hoi Kem...